No, that was
forever. Okay, well, welcome everybody. Welcome to the Tech Guy Some Guy podcast.
Yeah.
I am Carlos, along with
Rob.
And you know, this is the podcast where we talk about everything and nothing at the same exact time and make it sound cool.
Yeah. Oh, welcome to 2017, by the way.
Oh yeah, welcome to 2017. That's right.
Happy New Year.
Seen your ass since last year. Oh God, you really had to bug that. I haven't seen you since last year, Joe.
And what was that? About a week ago.
Oh, God.
All right.
I forgot about that. Okay, anyway.
How's your New Year?
It was good. I survived. it was good. It was good. I didn't get completely. There was like a lot of like family drama going on with like, you know, health issues with some family members, and there was death in the family and stuff like that.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
it wasn't too dramatic. You know, we didn't get too crazy or nothing like that. But it was still pretty good. I mean, the most interesting part, I never heard of this, is my brother busted out shot bottles, the little bottles of this rum called the Kraken.
I've seen it at Whole Foods.
On the side, it literally says, "Release the Kraken."
Yes.
Whoa.
How good was it?
The Kraken was released.
Okay.
it was good.
A little pause worthy, but okay.
It was good. Good time. You know? But yeah, besides that, not much else. Nothing crazy. I finally, because you've been bugging me for a while, I finally got to see Rogue One.
I stopped bugging. It was just one episode I bugged the shit out of.
Yeah, there you go. That's one episode too many, bro. And you were completely right. It was an amazing movie. If you haven't seen it, definitely go see it.
Yeah, IMAX, please.
Oh, yeah, definitely on IMAX. Like, the regular version, yeah, but...
Stop being cheap.
Yeah, IMAX that, because IMAX the hell out of it. Want to know what's the funny part, though?
What's that?
I took my son, right?
And I didn't ask you, did you go with...
I had to take the booger. And I took him to see it, and he was loving the movie. But I didn't know this. He was like it was during his Christmas break. So, like, you know, kids and Christmas break, like, I'm staying late as long as possible. Halfway through the movie, he gets knocked out.
What time did I go?
We went like the 1 o'clock to 1 o'clock in the afternoon one. And I'm like, dude, there's no reason. Right? And I know the chairs are comfy and everything like that, but next thing you know, he's gone.
Damn.
And I'm trying to tap him at the best parts and everything, and he's like...
Whatever.
I was like, you bastard.
I'm just going to enjoy it for the both of us.
I know, yeah. I was like, I ain't telling you nothing. Forget it. You're on your own. He wakes up. What happened? I ain't telling you.
You fell asleep.
It was like, you owe me 20 bucks.
Yeah.
I look at him like, yo, you owe me 20 bucks, man. Yeah. That's what it is.
Tack that onto your your debt.
Yeah, you're taking that off of your Christmas bonus. It was bad. So I don't know, did you actually bring show notes today?
I did.
Oh my God, two shows in a row.
I know, I'm getting it. That's another reason why I was late, because I was trying to finish up writing.
Oh, I'm so proud of you. Look at you.
Okay. There's a lot of stuff. There's nothing else really going on other than CES,
yes.
Since we do actually cover tech.
We really got to do that since, you know, it's Tech Guy, Some Guy. Right, it's been a lot of some guys. We gotta bring some tech guy stuff in.
I think there's been a balance.
That's true. I'm actually looking at some of the CES news.
It's a lot.
One of them was funny, and I only saw it like in a headline, and I never even looked into it. I don't know if you saw it, but they got virtual shoes, like virtual reality shoes.
Yeah. I saw something about that.
Hold on. I'm gonna look at it.
Before I start.
Yeah, you start with something.
You want me to start something?
Yeah, right. Start. How about that?
What we got here? Everybody got self-driving cars.
Of course.
Oh, that's
that.
That's
it's gonna turn on in a minute.
I feel like I'm sitting directly underneath the motor.
That's probably where the motor's at. Like right now,
it's
getting
massaged.
We're like,
what the fuck is going on?
Okay. So it's gonna turn back off in a second.
Oh Lord.
There it is.
Yeah, last episode it ended with it. That's only right that it begins. Everybody got self-driving cars. See, Tesla, you won. You paved the way. The blueprint for everybody to follow. Whether they were working on it or not, you beat them to the punch.
They let you kick your enemies. Ooh, VR shoes. But we'll talk about that in a minute. Like automated cars are, I think, Hyundai debuted.
Hyundai got the Ioniq. Toyota has a concept I, Mercedes has something there.
But wasn't Ioniq, wasn't a version of Ioniq at the International Auto Show last year?
I don't think, I think it was, but I don't think it was self-driving, or if it was, they wasn't advertising it.
Now, now it's all that.
But now I'm guessing the drive on its own. And then NVIDIA is actually working with Audi to have their self-driving vehicle up and running by 2020. Interesting.
Yeah, it's like, see, finally they did it. And it's already been going on for a while when Tesla started coming out with theirs. I mean, the reality is this, is within the next 20 years, automated driving is going to be everywhere. There's no way around it.
I'd probably say less than that. Yeah. They're already fighting it legally.
Yeah, but they're going to lose.
No. I'm just saying, like, that legal battle that would prevent it has already started.
Yeah.
And the companies are already, they're already working it out to get there. So, but like maybe 5 years, it'll be like good.
Right. I mean, the reality is this. If I remember correctly, automated vehicles is going to be something that is going to end up everywhere. There's nothing you can do about it. That's not your fault this time.
Jesus Christ.
Okay, no, not Jesus Christ, bro. That was Twitter.
That was Periscope.
Anyway.
But that I don't even use.
Okay, so automated driving is going to be everywhere. There's nothing you can do about that.
Go
okay,
ahead.
That's number one. Number two is that that because it's everywhere, even though there's a lot of resistance, most like I don't know from who honestly.
Resistance is futile.
Yeah, there's no point. See the problem that the world has, and mind you, this is just the world. I'm not even talking about this specific problem. The problem with everything is that human beings have a tendency to resist change.
Yeah.
We hate change.
Yeah.
And that's why there's so much, my opinion, there's so much turmoil within the past, let's say 50 years, because in the past 50 years, in the past 20 years, no, screw that, since the internet age happened, there's been so much resistance because the world has shrunk so much smaller.
Yeah.
I could catch a live feed on the traffic reports of Japan right now if I want to. You know what I mean? Like, you can do that. Like, yeah. you can, like, I personally have, I'm big and round, I like food. So I YouTube the hell out of what's awesome food in India, what's awesome food in Japan, in Morocco, just to see. You know what, the world has changed so much so that whenever a new technology comes out, the big wigs and everybody is so resistant against it because they think it's going to be a negative effect on them and their business. But the problem is that they need to understand that the business is going to change with or without them. There's nothing you can do about it. Ford.
Yes.
Ford actually announced that one of the plants in Indiana, Detroit, somewhere around there.
It's plants in the U.S.?
Technically.
Yeah.
They own the building. but what they're saying is that they're going to actually do a research, they're going to do a factory solely for automated driving and, what is it, automated driving and electric vehicles.
Yeah.
You know, so they're accepting the fact.
Something they can't outsource.
Right. But that's the thing. You can't. You have to accept the change. And CES is the one that's saying like, hey guys, it's happening. Screw y'all. It's gonna happen. So what we need to do is accept that change. I'm all for it. The only thing that I'm against, you know what I heard is automated driving is gonna affect the medical industry. Because there's going to be a lot less crashes. I don't know if you heard this.
I didn't think. I would say more so like town delivery, taxi, like that shit is finished.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Like, as an industry, like Uber was the start. Self-driving would be...
See, the interesting thing about Uber that I think is going to be an interesting thing to see. Because Uber, in the long run, is they want to go automated.
Yeah.
You know, and the interesting thing about that is that is if they're going to go automated, there's a lot of people that use Uber like almost like a full-time gig. And I'm like, guys, you guys need to understand, you can't get on Uber thinking that it's going to be a full-time job, a career changer, and anything like that. It's a temporary thing because Uber is using that to build their brand so they can advance their brand and go automated so they can have more profit in the long run.
Yeah.
Remember, Uber, if I remember right, Uber is publicly traded?
It might be.
Yeah,
so after a while, all these drivers are about to get the fuck out of here anyway.
Yeah, so it's like, you need to understand that, so. Yeah,
you're serving a purpose, that's all you're not, you know, people love to be like, oh man, this company came out with this and that, like, they're not really trying to help you, they're really about that dollar, or in their own.
Actually, Uber's still private.
Ooh.
But there was talks in September that they might go IPO in 2017. Currently, they're valued at roughly, as of last year, they were valued at $51 billion That's crazy.
What's that share price gonna be?
Oh, it's gonna be ridiculous. But I don't think they'll. You know what's funny? I don't think they'll go public. Only reason. Well, no, take it back. They have to go public. They don't got much of a choice.
At this point.
No, yeah, because a lot of their initial investors were like, all right, we're gonna have an initial investment, but I'm gonna want this amount of shares. So they're gonna have to go IPO. So when they go IPO, it's gonna be interesting.
Yeah.
But see, that's the thing about Uber drivers. Uber drivers need to understand that right now what we're really doing, what Uber drivers are doing is that they're working, they're making money, but they're also making money to the company so they could eventually go fully automated vehicles.
And
they already
get rid of you.
Exactly. And you know what? That's something you have to accept. They're a company just like everybody else. You know, they're willing to give you a cut as long as it helps them in the long run.
Yeah, I think anything else is just foolish.
See, but the funny thing is that you're right. There were a lot of vehicles. The funniest one, and we were talking off camera, and I might as well bring it up now. The Faraday demo.
Yeah, hey, I was gonna bring that up too. Might as well get into it. The Faraday future is an aggressively ambitious electric car company who wants to kind of take on Tesla, but they may be a bit overly ambitious.
Yeah, the FF91 is what they debuted.
Yeah, it looks.
Yeah, there's a picture. Man.
Yeah, it looks cool. It looks like something Nissan would make, so it's not like. It's cool. It's not like groundbreaking.
I want you to think about this. See that picture right there?
Yeah.
Doesn't it look like the Nissan Leaf? Think about the front of the Nissan
Leaf.
The
Leaf is kind
of
ugly, though.
I'm not saying it's a pretty
that
picture.
That looks better than the Leaf.
You know what I mean?
Yeah,
I don't know. The front of that looks like a Leaf.
I would be highly surprised if Nissan did not have a hand in that.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Whether influence or whatever. Go ahead. You're going to read those specs. 1,000 horsepower, 1,000 horsepower, 378 miles per charge.
1,050 bhp, battery pack reach 60 miles an hour under 2.4 seconds, claimed 378 mile range. That's a lot.
That's really good. I mean, but you got to keep in mind, it looks like a long car, but I think it's supposed to be an SUV type shit.
Yeah, I think so too. Then.
Crossover, I don't know, some shit.
I'm just looking. Oh, they're demanding a $5,000 deposit. That alone.
Yeah, they want $5,000 to get in.
And I think I heard in the rumorville that they're talking about that it's going to be a $180,000 vehicle.
Probably, but they didn't. If they want $5,000 up front, they didn't announce any type of.
Yeah, but if you want $5,000 up front, it's going to be a lot of money.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of money. They didn't announce any official pricing at the point. They had a demo. You saw the demo, right?
Yeah. See, but that's the thing. The demo's hilarious. Did you see the mess up on that?
Yeah,
please look it up on YouTube. It's a trip.
I'll put a link.
Right, please. Because what happened is that the Faraday is supposed to have automated driving. And one of the big things that they were announcing is like, yes, you know, put it on your driveway and you just hit the park and it'll drive itself into the garage. And they tried to demo it. And Faraday was like, nah, bro, I'm good.
Yeah, Teslas work better.
Yeah, like and that's the funny part, to debut it live and do that. You know, when those mess ups happen, it's hilarious.
Yeah.
And that's what happened. And so because of that, you know, it kind of made people be like,
you're not really ready yet.
Yeah,
right?
you ain't on that level. And honestly, I agree, you're not on that level. The problem that Faraday has as an electric vehicle, if the price range is in the six figure range, it's not going to succeed. And the reason being is because Tesla, which is, I'm sorry, it's an established brand. And their most expensive vehicle is like $70,000, $80,000.
No.
Yeah. Which one?
The Model X. Model X is around that price. Can go up to that price.
Really? Yes. Okay, I stand corrected.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that's.
And I don't know how much that Roadster cost when it came out, but that was like years ago.
I remember that Roadster.
That was the first. That was Tesla's first vehicle.
Let's see. Tesla X price. Price. There you go. But yeah, the thing with them is that they're already established. They're extremely established. The Model S, the upcoming Model 3, and Tesla Model S is at $68,000.
Yeah, I think you can probably get something like $60,000 now. Like, their price points keep getting lower and lower. They basically come out with different types of... It's essentially the same vehicle, but there's different battery trends that offer, you know, a little less than what you would get within the spec'd out version.
Exactly. And that's the thing about it is... let's see. I'm just looking through it right now.
Go for it. I mean, with the Model X, for me, it's all about the popping doors.
Yeah, but
if you take that away, it's kind of an ugly version of the S.
Yeah, I mean, for me, I would say just get the S or get the upcoming Model 3.
Okay.
And this is the thing, $5,000 deposit. Now everyone's doesn't have the funds for that. When they announced the Model 3 and they announced the $1,000 deposit.
And fight to not do it.
Dude, I'm telling you right now, like, I actually know, like, my go-to mechanic in Patterson, like, the middle of the hood, he was talking about it. He's like, yeah, I'll put $1,000 down, I'm ready. Like there's, like, regular people are going to buy this car.
Yeah, because it's the Model 3 isn't going to be crazily priced. It's going to be, like, like around like $35,000. And believe it or not, isn't that like the cost of like a cord or something? Like
yeah.
A brand new cord.
New cord is $35,000. Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's like.
And you're talking about running on electric, so it's like, fuck your gas bill and all other stuff.
See up here, go catch.
Fuck gas, oil change, all you gotta worry about is brakes.
$75,000.
For that Model X?
Yep, and with up to $90,000.
So go to the P.
And then, I was gonna say.
That's when you start doing six-figure range.
$138,000.
Yeah.
That's still $50,000.
Still cheaper than the Faraday's first vehicle.
Think about that.
Yeah.
The ultra mega top of the line Tesla is still cheaper than the Faraday. And the Faraday is an untested, unproven vehicle. And just like a lot of new technology, don't ever try to go for the first generation one. That's, you know what I mean?
Cause, yeah, because we bought the Tesla Roadster. I've seen a few, but you know.
If you talk to Elon Musk, the funny thing about him is that like they did it with this intention. The first vehicle we're going to do is going to be a very limited run, mm-hmm. and they're going to do that for the exclusivity and for the new technology and for the announcements. So they did that. I think they only sold like 5,000.
He knew what he was doing.
But the flag was there. They were like, all right, now we're going to go into a medium luxury, which is the Model S. Boom, they put that out there and people fell in love with it. Beautiful design.
I feel like there was a second vehicle.
No, it wasn't. It's the electric Roadster. It's the electric Roadster.
I feel like there was something in between the Roadster and the Model S.
Really?
Let's
look it up. But that's the thing. It's like that's what they were doing. And let's see. Autocorrect is funny sometimes.
Well, for each. Yeah. So. But oh, and by the way, if you have yet to test drive a Tesla, please do. There's Tesla stores all over. They don't encourage you to. You know, buy one. They just literally want you to just check it out. So here, check it out. Like we're dope. Just check it out. You'll fall in love with it. And then when you can't.
And I agree. I am gonna fall in love with it. Like I sat in one when I was done. Yeah, there's four of them.
I test drove.
Yeah, there's a four. There's the Roadster. There's the SX3.
Okay, so there was no one in between. No. But whatever the case, they're dope. I test drove them twice. Once before autopilot kicked
in. Both of them S.
Huh?
With the S?
Both S. I mean the Model X. I'm not like eager because I'm like it'll probably be like the same experience more or less.
Right.
Like I just don't fuck with the Falcon Doors and that's about it.
You're like give me Falcon Doors.
Yeah,
please.
But the autopilot is amazing. I told you they had us on 208.
Yeah, dude. The
shit was crazy. They're like yeah, like oh what?
Did you see the video? I think there was a video last week where there was a video of the Tesla predicted a car accident like 2 seconds before it actually happened.
I did not see that.
Dude, what happened is the video shows that there was a car. There's the Tesla, there's another car, and then there's another car in front of it. The Tesla didn't predict that this car was going to crash. The Tesla predicted that car was going to crash. And it broke before anywhere got in that area. And it was like, holy crap, it actually saw it coming. It actually saw it coming before anybody did.
Well, that's the thing. The autopilot and all the sensors, it's collecting road data from all the users. So it's kind of like Google Maps in a way, where it's like collecting road data, driving behaviors, you know, lanes, all that. All those sensors, you know, the car, you're paying for, you know, a freaking computer in a car that has all these sensors in it, and that's what it does. It compiles it and, you know, like I said, prediction like that.
Yeah, that was ridiculous.
Autopilot. That sounds crazy.
Yeah, like you gotta see the video. It's crazy because it's like holy crap! It predicted something so well that it actually stayed away from the whole area. Like that's nuts. You know what I mean? That's absolutely amazing. I'm actually just going through like CES news right now.
Oh, I got tons of stuff over here.
Dude, Razer has a 3-monitor laptop.
I was about to bring it. It's called the Valerie laptop.
Valerie?
It's a regular laptop, right? You flip it open, and then the monitor has two more, and they're 3 4K monitors. It's insane.
Is it just a concept, or is it a production?
I think it's a concept right now, but I mean, it's Razer, so I'm pretty sure they can make it a production. The question is, you know, is there a need for the price point? Because
hardcore gamers. That's a hardcore gamer.
No, it's hardcore gamers, but that would, you know, Razer, they don't skimp when it comes to specs anyway on their laptops. So I could, you know, potentially pretty much get rid of your desktop if you're a hardcore gamer like that and just do all that. And that's kind of dope. That's really dope. Again, stuff like that, this is what CES is all about, whether it be a concept or an actual real technology you can buy within the next month or two, and they'll show it off. It's like, hey, check out what we've been working on.
Yeah, and I had a feeling. I was like, there's no way that thing's using a laptop GPU, and I was right. It's using an NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1080. Is it the GeForce GTX 1080? That's the desktop.
Big desktop joint. Yeah, it has to, because there's no way, like you said, three 4K monitors? Like, yeah, right. It has to be pumping that big stuff. Let's see, so much to touch on.
There's a lot, dude.
I got some. I don't have everything. LG came out with a TV as thin as a credit card. It's a 77-inch, they call it the W7 Signature. It's a, it's a 4K OLED TV.
And it's 4K?
It's 4K.
That's nuts.
It has all four current technologies of HDR. Technicolor, Dolby Vision, all that shit. It's super thin, right? So you're like, all right, well, where is everything? It also comes with a Dolby Atmos soundbar, and that's where all the TV internals are.
It's in the soundbar?
Yes.
That's fucking genius.
And it actually looks really dope, too. It's hard to pick who has the better TV, LG or Samsung, but you can't lose either way if you get their top tier. I mean, you're going to spend a couple grand, it'll be worth it.
That's exaggerated, dude.
Yeah.
See, the funny part is that I remember when flat screens first started coming out, and people were like,
Plasmas were first, right?
Yeah, plasmas. And people were like, oh my god, it's only 4 inches thin. Now it's like, dude, it's a credit card.
Yeah.
That's awesome, dude. That's awesome. See, stuff like that is like, wow, really?
I mean, that's like, progress. Samsung also came out with, they also have a new TV. Instead of OLED, they're calling it QLED. So the difference between that and their OLEDs they're offering double the nits. So nowadays, everybody's upping their nit factor. And the nits is pretty much like...
But how's a nit?
A nit is... Let me see if I can explain this without having to look this up. It's the measure of brightness. It's not the brightness level, but it's like the overall brightness in regards to color reproduction. And, you know, think of it as aperture.
Okay.
So it's up in the brightness to make everything more clear and all that stuff as well. And then as well as up in the color reproduction. So, I mean, after a while, it's like, what else can you do?
You know what? I remember when 4K started debuting and that conversation started. It's like, how much more can TV technology go? Like, you've already gotten to the point where it's hyper-realistic, which it's looking beyond, it's looking so realistic, it's starting to look fake.
Yeah, because like, it's like, my eyes don't look, I can't, you know, we're at glasses before I grew over here.
Yeah.
Like, that shit don't even, like, you know, you looking at this chair over here off camera in 4K, yeah, and be like, that looks realer than in person.
It looks CGI.
Yeah.
Like,
looks like amazing CGI.
One of what's funny, in a photography point of view, when 4K started debuting, I don't know if you realize this, But TV makeup artists had to up their game up.
Because details.
You could see the details. Yeah. Even at 1080p, the details were still decently hidden, but at 4K, you could tell the foundation's thick. Like, you could tell the foundation is exaggerated thick.
Take their mask off, like, fuck superhero shit.
Exactly. So it's like, all right, now you guys are just on some stupid stuff, because these guys, like, it's gotten so hyper-realistic now. It's like, what new technology are you going to provide that is going to make it even clearer, even crispier? I can't even imagine it. But even us through all this talk, they're still making 8K. They're making 8K video cameras.
Oh, it's coming. So 8K screens are coming.
So it's like 8K video. It's like, why? Like, what possible use can we need?
Just cause.
You get what I'm saying?
Just cause. No real reason. There's no real reason behind
it. Yeah, because there's no, like, I mean, Jesus. Like, it's gonna come to the point where you won't even be able to tell the difference anymore. You know what I mean? Like even right now, like some, like even on Rogue One, there was a couple of CGI characters in there.
Two.
Yeah, there were two, literally a couple. That's what I said, bro. I said a couple. You said two. It's the same thing. Come on. Bastard. It's like, you're not wrong, but you're right.
Pretty much, yeah.
What was that?
One was good, one was not.
Yeah, but the funny part, even the one that was not was still extremely detailed.
It was.
I'm assuming you're talking about Tarkin.
That was what?
That was the one that was bad.
Oh.
Really?
Oh, Tarkin was great.
See, you know what's the problem with all CGI? All CGI actors? Don't worry about everyone.
I'm not saying. You know CGI.
Right. But the problem with them is that they could look so hyper-real, because Tarkin looked great, but his eyes ruined it for him. You know what I'm talking about? The eyes.
Not going to watch it again to see his eyes. I mean, dude, I'm just clips on
but mind you, this is because, like, me.
No Tarkin, yeah.
No, not even that. It's a photography thing. It's a video thing. Yeah, you could.
Boy. Yeah,
you're stupid. Yeah, you're stupid. Yeah, he goes way back. But the thing with him is that, like, his you could see it in CGI eyes. Like, you could see that, like, there's no life in them. And you really can't, it's hard to describe.
Gosh,
but you really can't see life in the eyes. And as much as it looks hyper-realistic, the eyes killed it.
Look at this soulless bastard.
Yeah! Like, you thought he was cold-hearted before. Like,
it's like, he's literally a shell. He's not even a real person.
You know what I mean? Let's see. I'm actually, holy crap. BMW has a holoactive cockpit. Bosch is debuting a cockpit of the future. Chrysler has a portal concept. Smart parking assistant is being created.
Alexa, the software that Amazon uses for their Echo, Tap, and their other connected shit.
What the hell is that?
That shit looked like a Happy Meal. Bosch, Wheel, Honda, New V. Yeah, they need to shoot themselves.
Oh my god.
Look at that.
It's autonomous. It's made for autonomous commuting. Jesus Christ, bro.
I mean, maybe it's...
No, you know what?
It looks, it's good enough to...
Look, for us American watchers, it looks like the kind of cars that you only see in Japan. It looks... Think about it. No, think about it.
Yeah.
Think about it.
But that looks bad even for that.
Yeah, that's pretty ugly.
Well, actually, Honda is a Japanese company.
Yeah.
But it looks bad for them. But, yeah, Alexa is everywhere. Alexa is... It's coming to a damn phone. They've teamed up with Huawei.
Oh, really?
Who's bringing them their Mate 9, which is pretty much their typical flagship. And they're bringing it to the U.S. finally, and it's going to be the first phone to ship with Alexa in it. So that's interesting. But wait, there's more.
Okay.
Lenovo's coming out with a connected speaker, kind of like Google Home.
Okay.
It looks like Echo, where it's tall and cylinder, but has the fabric on the bottom, like Google Home.
Okay.
It, too, is powered by Alexa. But wait. There's more.
Oh, damn.
Ford is bringing the power of Alexa to their vehicles.
Alexa in a car.
Yeah. It's like Google Home in a car.
Wow, you could have Alexa do like GPS.
Yeah, Hyundai bring Google Home and Google Assistant working together. So you could be like, all right, I'm almost done getting dressed. I'm about to go. It's cold. Like, okay, Google, start my car.
Wow, that's...
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Big thing to go on.
You know what time is it? How much time is it?
Yeah, you might as well.
Okay, hold on. Hold that thought real quick because I actually have something to say.
Yeah, I have something to say.
I got something to say about that, damn it.
Yeah, so.
There you go. Okay, so the thing that I have with it is, the problem that I got with it is the fact that with all this technology so much technology going into vehicles nowadays.
They make them shit unhackable.
Yeah.
Okay.
But see, there's a problem with that. The problem with that is that to have that kind of software in vehicles, you need to have a constant updating. Constant.
Kind of like a Tesla.
Right. Yeah. Because if you don't, what's going to end up happening is eventually someone's going to figure out how to break into them.
Oh, of course.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And so... What they're doing, remember we were talking about jobs and how jobs will be redirected into different things. We were talking about the Amazon store.
Here's
a perfect example.
Yeah.
What these car companies are going to have to eventually do, I think, is that they're going to have to start developing literally like net security for their vehicles, all their vehicles, and they have to keep it running. Non-stop.
Yeah, because that's going to have to go hand in hand. You can't have automated
exactly.
And all this technology and leave the back door open for security. Like,
right. Because for like the last thing that you want is for somebody to find a loophole and get into your car anytime they want.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Somebody hack the shit. Yeah, have it self-drive to a fucking bank or some shit.
Exactly. Yeah. See, that's something you have to be... I hope the car manufacturers look into the bigger picture and figure that out.
Yeah.
Because that's something that they're definitely going to be looking at, and you're going to look at it and say... You know what? How come somebody didn't think about this?
Yeah, because it's like, obvious safety concern.
Right, you got to be an idiot to look at it, and say it's not gonna, like, somebody's not gonna think of that.
Hey, some people are all about that cash grab, so they might slip through the cracks.
For real. That, you know what? That's the problem. And
not all companies. I'm pretty sure there's a few companies that say, nah, we'll be all right.
Nah, we'll be all right. We're good. Yeah, I'm like, yeah, all right.
Yeah, like, whatever, idiot.
Exactly. So that's something that they need to be made aware of, or they need to really focus on, because if you do something like that, the bigger picture is gonna make itself known real quick, because the moment somebody creates a new technology, there's somebody out there that wants to break into it just to see if they can. There's hackers that just do it for sport, just to see if they could.
Yeah, when we were in high school, there were people. The guy hacked the White House.
Remember that?
Yeah. Yeah.
That was long before.
Was that like 1997? 1996,
I think. Jesus it was. Christ. I know we're old now.
That's some damn.
Again, we aged ourselves all over again, bro.
We old, man.
Yeah. I'm an old man. My back hurts, bro.
Pain, shit. You know,
I told you, I've been taking me forever to get out of bed nowadays. I'm getting old, bro. It's all good. But yeah, I mean, that's the thing that I have with it. Is like, they really need to beware of what's going to end up happening. So, yeah, I mean, am I excited for the automated vehicles and the smart vehicles and
that's
stuff like that?
That's what I was going to say. Like, what are your thoughts on it?
I think it's cool. I mean, like if they do it right, if they execute it properly, I would love to be in my car and be like, yo, listen, can you turn up the thermostat in my house by 5 degrees?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Or I'm in my house and be like, yo, can you turn on the car? I would love that. Yeah. Like, just because, like, humans have a tendency to, it's all about our convenience. That's why we developed all this technology. Not because we need it, but because we want to be lazy and be comfortable.
Lazy as shit, yeah.
Bro, you know what I'm saying?
Yo, I want a machine to do push-ups for me, but I still reap the benefits.
Let's get that muscle-making one, the twitching one.
Shake weight?
Oh, the shake weight, bro.
He said, oh, I want a pump.
Yo, I want to know, remember you were talking about cash grab? Who the hell did not see that coming?
Yeah, but I bet you they made money just off of just the novelty
factor. Oh, the novelty factor, hell yeah. You know how many people bought it as a novelty for their, like, their dad?
Yeah. Just whatever spike, they made their money, like, thanks.
Yeah, they were like, thanks, run out like a bandit, man. Yeah, you know what? All those seen on TV things are always...
They make money.
Oh.
Don't sleep, they make money. If you ever watch Shark Tank, there's a fucking a niche market for... Well, it's niche. It's pretty big. It's not really niche, but it's definitely a market for it where even if they only last for a while, that limited time, they can make X amount of money.
And that's it. Good. Yeah, and smash and grab. Dumb. That's literally a smash and grab. They come in here, boom, I'm out. Done.
It's like pop-up shop. It's pretty much what a pop-up shop is.
Exactly.
Ideas from.
Yeah, you know what's funny? A lot of CES news is saying, yo, Alexa's everywhere.
Alexa's everywhere.
Google. Alexa's which one? It's Google? No, it's not
that's
Google.
That's Amazon's.
Amazon.
Google is a bit more. Like, Google Assistant also, I said, is coming, working with Hyundai in regards to their Blue Link app. But it's also coming to the NVIDIA Shield, which is their, like, you know, Android TV gaming thing. Yeah.
You know what it just hit me? Talking about the Alexa being everywhere thing, it kind of smacked Siri in the face.
Siri, no one used Siri from day one.
Right, but remember when they were talking about the Apple's gonna be eventually making a car and stuff like that?
They're still talking about that, but
right,
they're
but taking but, time. But Alexa already beat them. Think about it. They're like, we don't need to make a car. We just need to sell it to the car.
Google effect. Already beat them. Yeah. Google got them in one car. That shit ain't even out yet. Siri, that's the thing. When Siri first came out, it was cool because it's like, all right, it has sass, has personality, whatever. It didn't really do shit.
No.
It kind of does stuff now. Alexa was like, okay, that's a prime example of what Amazon Alexa, they're like, that's a prime example of what not to do. Let's make our service actually functional.
Do something.
Instead of just, you know, for common purposes. Like, here, ask Siri this. Out of here. Like, I want you to do something. If I can, you know, that first version, you couldn't tell turn on Bluetooth or Wi-Fi.
Right.
You had to just, you know, look up Google search shit, whatever.
Yeah, like, and see, that's the thing about it. It's like, Siri was the first one, but everyone else saw what Siri was capable of and said, yo, you guys are not doing it, we are.
Yeah, you're not doing enough.
Yeah, so like, that's...
Siri lazy as shit.
Yeah, so that's exactly what happened.
Yeah.
And I think it's showing now because Alexa's literally going into cars. Apple's been talking about cars for years, and now they're actually doing it. And
it's still not out yet.
No, I'm sorry. I'm talking about, like, Alexa's actually doing it.
Oh, well, yeah.
They're like, oh, we've been here a shorter time, but you know what? We're smart enough to actually put it out there into other vehicles. Like, so let them make money off of us. We make money off of them, you know, and it makes our brand bigger. Of course, they're doing a great job, you know. And if it works out the way they want it to work out, fine, great. Now, I hope to God that the technology is there for the security part. That's the only concern I got.
Only concern,
you know what I mean?
Very true.
Yeah, that's really the only main concern I have. Like, when it comes to technology-wise, the world is going to change with it. Matter of fact, I was talking to my mechanic friend. He's an old-school mechanic. He's been working in cars since, like, carburetor days. So we were talking about, like, the new cars. He goes, dude, some of these new cars, some cars that have 128 computers in.
Yeah.
He goes, like, for an old-school guy, dude, we're going to retire soon, and the new generation is going to have to step the game up because...
They got
to
learn IT as well as the...
Yeah, they got to learn IT, shit. Yeah. It's on some other level stuff, so...
Which is fine, because that makes, you know, that could become transferable skills, which is always valuable these days.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, nobody wants to be a one-trick pony.
Definitely. What else you got for me?
New Chromebooks.
Really?
Yes. Google teamed up with Samsung. Samsung already made Chromebooks. Like, you have one.
Is mine the Samsung?
Yeah.
Okay.
You have one. You have the Chromebook 2. Old ones.
I love Chromebooks.
Huh?
I love Chromebooks.
No, Chromebooks are... I've been a Chromebook... I've probably been a very few of, you know...
Yeah, the thing with this...
I've been a big Chromebook advocate because I saw what it was and what it could do. I'm like, this isn't for people who's trying to do shit. This is for everyday people. This could be for... people's parents, kids.
Yo, every college student needs to have a Chromebook, honestly.
Depending on what they do, but it can.
No, screw that. If you're a film dude.
In the arts.
In the arts.
Yeah, yeah.
Everything else.
Yeah, just get a Chromebook. Fine.
Everything else. I don't care if it's like, what do you call it? Like liberal arts and writing, yeah. English, history,
sure.
Everything else. Like, that does not require heavy graphical interface use. Get the damn Chromebook. Why the hell are you spending? Because the thing that bugs the... You know what? Okay, we're about to go into Family Guy. You know what really grinds my gears? These college-ass students, right?
College-ass students.
Yeah, no, I age myself again. These college students who go there and they're like, I'm going to have my... I'm going to have my Mac Pro so I could write my thesis on whatever. It's like... So basically, you're buying a multiple $1,000 laptop just so you could use the Word doc.
like you can do that shit on your fucking phone.
Yes, that's the thing. It's like, why?
Like, Logitech has a Bluetooth keyboard. You can set your phone up and just
get the hell out of here.
But that's it. It supports up to like 3 or 4 devices.
So what you're trying to say is that it doesn't even you don't even need the Chromebook. It's like,
well, no, you still need it,
But you get what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, yeah. It's not like necessary.
You do not need to have the big fancy Apple glowing logo for you don't need it.
Oh.
But
it doesn't glow anymore in the new touch
bar. You could tell.
It took it away. Like, you idiots.
Yo, matter of fact, you haven't reported this.
What's that?
Did you hear this is the first time Consumer Reports did not...
Oh, I didn't write about it, but yeah.
Consumer Reports has been putting the Mac Pro on their list of must-buy technology for 18 years.
Don't buy this shit this year.
This year, they were like, nah, don't. And Apple's contesting it.
They was like, nah, let's get together. He's like... Ain't nothing to talk about. You made shit this year.
Yeah, that's exactly. Yo, Consumer Reports is like, sorry, man. Nah.
Do better next year.
So. Honestly, that blew my mind. That was like, wow, Consumer Reports. Because the thing about Consumer Reports, and before anybody is like, oh, well, it's whatever. Consumer Reports, honestly, is probably one of the most respected magazines in general. Just because they don't care what the companies think. They're there to rip them apart. And they actually are basically, they keep the companies in check when they mess up.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
Like, this is long before blogs like us.
Oh, they've been around over 50 years. Stuff.
Yeah.
Over 50
it's
years.
It's a real thing. Like, and I commend them for still...
for them to do that.
To still keep around relevant and still maintain their legacy.
Yeah, it was crazy. And
then they call Apple out on their bullshit.
Like, they did. They called them so out. And Apple was contesting, but like, we don't care. We do not recommend it.
Yep.
We don't, and you know what? If you look at it, I don't recommend it. The fact that there was another company out there that they created. Did you see the two-pronged dongle that goes into the Thunderbolt thing? And it actually matches it?
Yeah.
So it could have all.
I talked about it.
Yeah, remember that?
The Hyper thing. I talked about it last episode.
Right.
Yeah.
That one is like, it's sad when Apple, which is one of the biggest companies in the entire world, literally makes something and says, you guys are going to love this. And the whole world literally says, no, we're not. And we start showing them how much we don't like it. Like, we're showing them, like, like Consumer Reports says no. We got other companies that are saying like, listen, your dongle thing, well, you guys are idiots. Here, I'm gonna create money so I can make money off of you guys. So you guys could try to correct yourself and make it up. But now that added piece is huge. And that's another thing, visually, it matches how the Mac Pro looks, but it still doesn't change the fact that now all of a sudden it got like 2 inches wider. You know what I mean? It doesn't change the fact. Like, you guys are really, they made a huge mess for themselves. That has to be like one of the biggest like screw-ups ever.
I mean, yeah. I mean, even the fucking iPhone, the iPhone 7 doesn't sound like people thought they would. They thought they would.
But see, that's the thing. When the thing with smartphones is it's gotten extremely competitive, and people are starting
aggressively competitive.
Yeah, and people are starting to see that it's not about brand anymore, but what it can do. Like, personal opinion, LG G5. I absolutely do not like this phone. Okay, camera is great. I love the camera. Everything else, like I showed you the burn monitor thing and everything like that. The image burn on the screen is horrible. And for me, that annoys the living hell out of me. So I can't wait till this is up and I'm just going to get me a new one. Like, whatever. I'm not knocking LG. I'm knocking that specific phone.
Just that phone, yeah.
You know, and that's the thing about it. Like I cannot knock one company when they have one item and then the next item is awesome. This specific one just was bad for me. Does that mean I'm going to knock LG? No. Like, because the V20 is dope.
Yeah.
The V20 is like, damn,
V10
I wish I had
the... dope, but I've never reviewed it, so I don't know.
LG, what's your problem, bro? You know, he's a tech guy right here.
Their PR company is weird. Like, sometimes, like, they reached out for the G5, like, maybe 5-6 months after it came out. Like, hey, you want to review this? Like, what?
Sure, reviewed it, like...
I didn't review it already. I got it from Verizon. Fuck you, man.
Yeah, like, oh. Guys, thank you, but no thank you. You know what I mean? Nah. So what else they got?
All right. I was talking about the Chromebook. Samsung. Not one, but two. So Samsung teamed up with Google to make it like the premier Chromebook. Like the Chromebook. I mean, everybody's still coming out with them, but it's like, yo, we're Google official.
Okay.
So it's two Chromebooks. It's called the Plus and the Pro. So the Pro has the fucking stylus. Has pretty much the note pen in it.
Really?
Yeah. And then It can fold back like tablet style and write on it and work with notes, and it'll support Android apps out the gate. And then
that's the thing we were talking about too.
Yeah, and then the Plus will have a core M3 processor inside.
Really?
Yeah. They start at
I'm assuming that means fast.
It's
I don't want to sound like an idiot person.
You stupid. The Core M's are pretty good because they're always good on battery life. I think the Core M's is perfect for the Chromebook line because usually Chromebooks, they use like Celeron. What did yours have? You remember?
I think it's Celeron.
Yeah, using Celeron, old ass processors that, I mean, they're fine. They're no complaints.
They do their job.
It's like, all right, we can, you know, you got other, Intel has other chipsets in their product inventory. You use something. I mean, the Chromebook Pixel, those had fucking i7s in them shit.
Wow. Yeah, that's crazy.
Yeah, but the i3, and they start at 450, so I'm definitely looking forward to checking
450? That's not bad. See, like, for me, a Chromebook, I wouldn't want to go, like, that would be the highest I would consider paying
that,
for.
Yeah.
Don't go higher than that.
You shouldn't pay.
Yeah, because then
you start getting 500-600, you might as well just buy
exactly. That's what they need to, like, they need to keep the Chromebook at a budget, because I love the 200, 300.
They still have those, though. It's not like they got rid of them. It's just, like, of course, Samsung, being Samsung, they're not going to come out with, well, they did at first, but now I don't see them making a...
Well, actually, wait. The Plus version is 450, but not the Pro. The Pro price hasn't been announced yet. So the Pro's going to be higher than 450.
Yeah.
Like, they're going to be pushing their luck on that one.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Samsung, I love Samsung. They got a lot of stuff. Sometimes they just make stuff just to make it.
Yeah.
And like, if it works, it works. If not, we're cool either way.
That's the thing about Samsung is that they have so many products. Like, they could run, take
create
risks.
A web of
they
things.
Could take risks.
They're like, it'd be a hack.
Yeah, that's the thing. They could take risks. And that's one cool thing about them. Like, they can seriously, seriously take risks. Even with the whole
Note fiasco,
it's, if you look at the percentage of how much they lost, it's just a small percentage to their total income of the year. It really didn't like hit them as much as people think it did.
Yeah.
Only the phone side did. Everything else, like they're good. Like people forget, if you look at the list of how much Samsung has, like what are all their products?
They make
Korea.
They make everything stupid. They make stuff for everything. They bowed out of the camera business, which sucks because the cameras actually pretty good.
Yeah, but the competition in the camera stuff was crazy.
No, it wasn't that. It was just the fact. I think the only way that would have worked is they were like, if the mount was compatible with like a Nikon or a Canon.
Yeah, that's never gonna happen.
I know that wasn't. But that's the only way that would have worked, because nobody's gonna leave what they've known and love and right, get a whole new camera system.
I wouldn't at all.
As far as like professional photographers, like, you're not pulling people away.
No, you're never gonna pull me away from.
Yeah, you're the only Nikon shooter I know.
No, you know what? Please.
You are, though. I'm pretty sure.
But damn it, the pictures come out awesome. I don't care.
No.
But the funny thing about it is that I've played around with the Sony A7 series.
I don't need that. I could just get an A65 call it a day.
That's the thing. Even, was that the...
Any X7.
Give me that one. This is the camera that you use for a lot of your film stuff.
Everything with that.
Okay, it's a Sony NEX7. Okay,
it's old as shit.
Yeah, but it's still amazing.
I know.
I would get this camera.
I kind of don't want it. Only reason I would upgrade is for faster autofocus for videos.
Now the problem that I have with this is the hot shoe. It's just this piece right here.
It's proprietary.
Which sucks. Which is stupid. Everything else is awesome.
So you have to buy. Like, I have it. It's like a little $10 piece. You just click on.
Yeah, see, the fact that you have to have a piece is the same problem that Apple has with their dongle thing.
Yeah, like, except the dongle is $10.
Yeah, see,
$30, $1,700 for
right.
the dongle.
And see, that's the thing with this is a camera like this, which came out 3-4 years ago.
Yeah, it kind of started the mirrorless thing.
Yeah,
like, it made mirrorless a thing, a real tangible thing. Like, oh, this could work.
See, and this is the thing. This camera here is a good couple of years old. It is a crop sensor camera, if I remember right.
APS-C.
It's a crop sensor camera, but it still has 24 megapixels. The bokeh probably is not that great on it, but I've played with this, and the image quality on this is absolutely ridiculous. For a good camera, okay, I'm just about to go into a quick shopping
thing. Go for it.
If you're on a budget and want to make good video and good and take good quality pictures without breaking the bank, you could probably find a used one of these for cheap as hell.
They're cheap. Because you can find like the A5100s for like, shit, you got the A6000 out right now for like $400 on sale. No lens, but still.
Let's see.
With lens, it's 600. I think it was like $1,000.
I'm just checking the shopping thing. Let's see shopping.
Yeah, how much did the NEX7 go for?
This was like 1,000, wasn't it?
It was 1,000 when it came out.
Okay, it was 1,000 when it came out. And let's see. Here we go. Here's the used ones. Used ones is $300.
KEH.com is a great place if you're looking for used camera or lenses.
$300 used. Okay? It was a $1,000 camera a couple years ago. It's $300 now. 24 megapixels, 1080p video.
You got an audio jack, and you still have does it have an HDMI?
Yes.
You have a full-size HDMI.
So okay, yes. Completely random out of the blue. Budget-wise, I would get this phone. I would get this camera. I really would. The only problem that I would have with it, honestly, is the fact that it has its own proprietary Sony mount. But whatever.
Yeah, you know, the lenses aren't that bad. Like this was like, what, 200? I would call it the 50 cal. The 50 millimeter f/1.8 is I think 200.
And mind you, I'm looking for lenses. So they have lenses.
Yeah, 200.
Yeah, 50 millimeter. Is that what this is?
Yeah.
Okay, 50 millimeter 1.8. This is like for camera for photographers. This is the Nifty 50.
Yeah.
It's $200.
I call it 50 cal.
Okay. Here's a funny thing about it. Like, and matter of fact, hold on a minute.
Let's go. Now we're on camera talk.
Now we're on camera talk. I don't know.
Respect the shooter.
Hold on. I have a 50 mil. Here it is. Okay. This is I'm like, what the hell did I break?
I don't know.
Okay. This is a 50 millimeter 1.8 Nikon lens.
Is that a newer one or is that a classic one?
No, this is a newer one.
Okay, it looks like a classic.
Actually, wait, I think it is a classic.
So that has a classic look to it.
Like, if you look at this, there's something right there that I'm like finding weird. This is $130 new. You could probably buy used for anywhere between $80 to $90. This lens is $200. Those are the little things that bug me.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
Sony.
Yeah. Sony and
they always overcharge.
Yeah.
Everything.
Okay. And the funny thing about these lenses is that these lenses, Nikon is famous for having the same exact mount on all their cameras since like the 1960s, I think.
Canon has something similar too, right?
No, they didn't. That's the thing.
Oh yeah, because you gotta buy, if you buy an older lens, you gotta buy an adapter.
Yeah, so they don't. I could literally buy a lens from the 1980s for Nikon and put it on my new Canon.
It's a plus point for
Nikon. Yeah, that's one thing I've always liked about them. So like, you could go to KEH and find a whole bunch of Nikon used lenses that they don't even make no more and stuff like that. So yeah, that's. But for like a regular person. This is dope.
Quick settings are amazing on it.
Exactly.
I mean, of course, if you're shooting like sports photography, I wouldn't go crazy with that because you know all the pictures is outdated. What are you looking at?
They have a 420mm to 800mm 8.3 super telephoto lens.
200.
For $200.
Jesus Christ.
Look, here's a 55 to 210. Yeah, they got a whole bunch of different lenses.
Yeah, I need that. I need either. Next lens I'm gonna get, if I don't get a new camera, I may just get a lens. Tempted to get.
Yeah. Well, you know what? See, this is the thing. It's like how long can you use equipment before people start, you know, the quality starts coming down.
I'm not having any quality issues at all.
With that thing, you shouldn't. And yeah. That's the thing. You really should.
Sometimes the battery overheats, which is annoying.
Get new batteries.
I just bought a new one.
Yeah. So just get more batteries. Yeah. So that's all.
But that's about it. That's only if I'm shooting for like 10 minutes. We're okay.
Okay. So yeah, there's that.
Yeah.
So FYI.
Camera talk over.
I want to see. Wait, you know what? You're talking about that. Go ahead. Pull something else up.
One more thing. CES. You know how you talk about Google Wi-Fi and Eero and all these other mesh Wi-Fi networks. Now, Linksys, ASUS, and Belkin.
All stepping the game up, huh?
Yep. Is it Belkin? It's not Belkin. It's No, D-Link, I'm sorry, that's what it is, D-Link. So Linksys, ASUS, and D-Link, they've all announced their versions of mesh Wi-Fi networks as well for CES, so.
Really?
Competition is rolling.
Well, that's good. See, and remember something, this is the thing, competition is what everybody wants, because more competition there is, the better, the people who win out is the consumers. Us. Because,
prices.
Yeah, prices. Because they're like, oh, well, you know what, I'll be able to offer you the same thing, but cheaper, and everything like that. Look, D-Link unveils a HomeKit-enabled security camera with 180-degree field of view. That's good.
Yeah.
That was 3 hours ago they announced that.
Yeah, there's a lot of other CES news. There's tons.
That's the funny thing about it.
I do what I can. A lot.
Yeah, but see, the thing with CES is that there's absolutely no way you can cover everything.
No, that's why when you go out there, you need a team of a minimum of 3 to 5. Even team of 2 won't be enough because there's meetings with companies and they're off-site and the showroom floor is big as shit. And, you know, and you might miss something cool, like a company you've never heard of might come up with the coolest shit and it's, you know, in a corner somewhere and you have to scour the entire floor to find it. I only went to CES once and my experience was actually really, really good.
It
was lots of fun.
Loved it.
No, lots of fun. Not a lot of sleep, but it was just always something to do. There's parties down there every night. You really don't have to worry about food too much. I mean, there's breaks in between the showroom floor and whatever the parties, of course, that. But during the time on the showroom floor, you get free lunch if you're press. And then at night, the parties. You know, open bar, and it's usually like hors d'oeuvres or something, or full food. So you got a lot to choose from. And then
I got something to that's for. Interesting.
The GH5.
Yeah.
I didn't talk about GH5. I'm literally just writing that.
Lumix. It's a Panasonic. It's a Panasonic.
You know, GH5 is Panasonic.
No. The thing is that it's like. Sometimes you still get surprised. It's like, wow, they're really trying to step. They're really trying to compete with like.
No, they are.
You know what I mean?
But the thing is, with GH, the GH4, The GH4 was really big among YouTubers because, and some videographers, Omar, who was here last week, he has GH4. He's actually excited for the GH5. I forget, he texted me. I texted him, like, hey, you joined us out. What do you say about it?
4K, 30 frames a second, 10 bit.
Yeah, he's pretty good with it. It's slightly better low light. It's nice. Of course, he's a little off with the price point.
What's the price point?
$2,000.
Ooh.
Yeah. He's like, you might get the A6. You might have to go to A6500. The A6500 is more expensive than others, but it's still like 12, 13.
See, that's the thing. I mean, see, going back to this,
it's like... you don't have S-Log. You have to get that later.
See, I'm the first one to admit, competition is good. And for new companies to try to go up there and challenge some of the bigger companies is always a good thing. But if you're going to do it, make sure you do it at a competitive pace. Because it's not competitive at all.
That's competing with, like, the Canon Mark D, which is, like, 5 grand.
Hell, that's competing with, like, the Nikon. That's competing with, like, the Nikon.
Yeah.
D750, which shoots. Actually, I think we're shooting a... Matter of fact, we're filming this on the D750.
There you go. But see, the thing with that is, it's a jump because... The GH4 was, I forget what much of it was, like 12, it may have been like $1,200. And then to go then near double at $2,000, it's like, all right, what more are you doing? Not what more are you doing, like, all right, you're doing more, but is it really worth the $2,000? So, I don't know. I mean, you know, you're doing some photo stuff. Supposed to be video.
I'm looking at the photo stuff, and the photo stuff sounds interesting.
But will it be good at execution wise?
I wouldn't. See, the only reason why I wouldn't is like I wouldn't buy this for photo. The problem with it is again the lens selection.
It's a video thing.
Yeah, it's a video thing. And even for a video thing, you still have to pay $2,000 plus whatever lenses to go with it, or adapters for it.
Yeah.
And it's like, what's the point?
Yeah. So anyway. I don't know. It's crazy with the whole thing, but So it's supposed to be video friendly, but I mean, I don't know. For me, like, he's an Nikon guy. I'm kind of a Sony guy. I don't see me leaving Sony as a main camera. I could definitely see me picking up a Canon or a low pan Sony.
You know what I would love to do?
There's smaller ones as like a secondary camera.
What I would really, really, really love to do is
shoot with that.
Yeah. Well, actually, I wouldn't mind shooting with this. But what I would really like is for Sony to step up and offer and try to see if you could get in touch with Sony, and see if you could get whatever is this model's camera, not the A7s.
No, it'd be like the equivalent of that.
Yes.
Now it would be the A63, A65.
Because I would love to shoot with that. The only reason why I don't want to shoot with like the A7s and stuff like that is because that's already done. Like, you know what I mean? And to get a camera like this and make it competitive and see if you could actually do it on my level would be really interesting. I wouldn't mind trying that. So
like, I might change them just so that.
I didn't say that. That didn't come out of my mouth. You know what I mean?
Curious. The low light on Sony's are actually pretty good.
Really?
Not that you shoot, you know, like I shoot in studio.
But see, but that's the thing.
If I shoot in studio, I don't give a fuck about low light. I got light.
yeah. but the funny thing is that the Nikon sensor at low light is actually still very good. I actually shot some images with it, and it's dope. Like, it really could handle low light.
That's for sure.
Like, you know, so the more interesting thing is what is it gonna do in the what the new generation cameras are gonna do? Because from what I could tell on CES, not a lot of really new cameras got announced.
No.
Which most of the time they go like at Photokina and stuff like that. You know,
and other ones.
Me neither. Like, see, that's the thing with me is I don't go to a lot of shows, and the only reason why I don't is honestly I'm just tired. Like, I have no reason to not go to them. I go to the International Auto Show.
Yeah.
To cover it for you, yeah. And I go to I go to cover for him. You know, I'm definitely gonna be going to
Photo Plus.
Yeah. I have to admit, Photo Plus is dope.
Yeah, but I'm saying they have a lot of stuff. Well, the other thing, those are local.
Right.
Oh, you got stuff like NABJ. Not the NABJ East, but the NABJ that'd be in Vegas.
Yeah.
Like, that's probably crazy, but it's in Vegas.
Yeah, exactly. See, so. You know what's the problem with Vegas is, you know, I have a married wife. And I'm married and I have a wife. And, yeah, she'll probably kick my butt. You going to Vegas by yourself?
I went to Vegas by myself a couple of times.
Yeah, well, you know what? The funny part is that, the interesting part is that me and my wife, we have a very, very, very trusting relationship. Same. But... the stereotype of Vegas.
Well, you used to be a piece of shit, no, stop.
No,
I'm kidding.
I'm not. You could admit it. I'll say it. Hey, look, I have an incredible...
but Vegas is, you know what? Vegas is, it's interesting. It's not what, it can be what you think it is, but it, on the surface, that's not really what it is.
You know what? I'm kind of with you on that. It's making her believe that. It's making her understand that.
Shit. Both of y'all, but they don't call
but,
it that.
But you know what's the funny part? You know what's the funny part? In situations like that, I probably will end up making it a vacation thing with her.
That's what I'm saying. Like, you go out there and make a vacation.
Qualcomm kicks its automotive ambitions up another gear, partners with Volkswagen.
Yeah. Qualcomm. And they released the new 835 chip. So, yeah, everybody's doing something for CES.
Okay.
Lots of these. But yeah, Vegas is cool. I mean, it's weird going out there and see, like, families.
Well, you
see families walking on this side, and you see
high price escorts on the other.
No, hookers leaving with.
Look, I was saying high price escorts, bro. Why you had to bring it, make it sound like hookers?
Those hookers boys. Leaving with really old men, looking very obvious on the other side.
Welcome to Vegas.
But bro. You know, it's just whatever. I mean, it's just all it is like kind of like a New York style life, where it's like 24 hours in this nice little area.
I got an interesting question for you.
What's up?
Because of all the stuff that we're getting in CES right now.
Yeah.
And I know we talked about it a little bit last week, but right now, like this upcoming year, I'm assuming you didn't have any resolutions. Did you do any resolutions or anything like that?
No.
Okay. So what's like the big thing you personally are looking forward to, like, in 2017? What's like one, from what you could see right here, with what you see at CES going on right now, what's the one thing that you think will be like, yeah, you know what, I can't wait for that. I can't wait to see that in person.
Probably cars.
The cars?
What these cars look like in person. I've done the Tesla thing, so I'm curious to see what everybody else's shit look like, even at this infancy stage of whatever they're working on. I mean, I'm not, that's the thing. I've been doing this for a couple of years now.
Oh.
As far as... you know, as far as just covering and seeing stuff. So after a while, I'm not immune to it where it doesn't excite me, but it's just like I'm not as excited as I would be, say, 5-6 years ago.
I think I want
to... I'm still interested. I still...
I want to see that credit card TV. From what you made it sound like, I definitely want to see the credit card TV. I want to see what Volkswagen has up its sleeve this year. I definitely want to see what VR is going to do this year. Oh, we didn't even mention it, but like I brought it up at the beginning, like VR feet, you can actually kick people.
Oh, yeah.
Just for the, like, see, the funny thing about CES is that they have a lot of really the nice fancy ones,
mm-hmm.
but then they got some really stupid ones,
like
too.
Like they have radiation blocking underwear. Like you said, stupid shit.
Like why? Like
CES, you'll see, like you can, if I had it my way, financially or even sponsorship-wise, I would go to CES with a crew, and I would have video team covering this and that, and then I would have a couple people like, yo, go handle the dumbest shit you see on CES.
Like, find the stupidest thing.
You will find a lot.
Weirdest tech, CNN, weirdest tech from opening day. Let's see what they have. But that's the thing about CES, is like, they don't just show the big announcements that'll change the future. They also have those real little ones that
little
are like,
ones, big things that are really good that you never
heard. The hell is that? Oh, that's the race car from Saturday.
Yeah,
okay.
That looked good.
Yeah, that looked kind of dope. Hair coach.
Yeah, it's a smart comb.
It's a smart comb, bro.
Smart brush.
Smart brush. Let's see. Love box.
Love box.
Oh, man.
Oh, modern day message in a bottle. I was going to say, what do you put? What my question was like, what the fuck do you put in the bottle?
Yo, yeah. You know what? If you have a really perverted mind.
That's what I was going. I was like,
look,
you put
love box.
In there? What is going on?
That, look, love box. That. Your
like,
mind is like.
Yeah, like, can you fit in it? Like,
is it long enough?
Ha
Woo! Oh, yeah.
Love box. Oh, they want $120 for the love box.
No, sorry.
Yeah.
Cat's Pat, a smart pet assistant.
Oh, that's
an automated bowl.
It's a smart feeder.
Man, how much? Oh, it's a Kickstarter for $200. I love my cat, but not $200. Like,
there are people who love their cat and like Kickstarter, eh?
Yo, there's people who love their cat. There's like, he's dying. Surgery's like $2,000. Anything for him. I'm like, motherfucker, dad. Like, stop letting him go. I love him. He understands.
And he, as bad as it sounds, he's a cat person.
I am a cat person.
Like, he has
I have two cats. I have two cats.
Yeah.
If one of those cats is going to cost me $2,000, I love him. I remember him forever. I take a nice picture. Yeah. I'm cool. Yo, dude, I'm cool. But you know what? Like, I got, there's a lot of people that I love. I love my wife. I love my two kids. I love the baby that's on the way. And I love my two cats. Okay?
But if you have
there's to a pick. Hierarchy
yeah, yeah,
in
yeah, yeah,
this.
Yeah. Nah.
This, like, it is what it is, yeah, man.
There are people like, yo, sorry.
Well, you guys Trump's got more money. You guys got more money than I do.
Yeah. Trump's all like, fuck that.
A camera for your fridge.
But Samsung already has that.
Lord.
So you see, but their camera is for like, you can touch the outside and be like, all right, I'm low in this.
Hold on, I'm pulling up the article from the Irish Times. It's just the fact that it says the Irish Times, they probably have something more entertaining. Yeah. If there's not something liquor related, I'm going to be mad. Reality shoes. I told them. They actually have reality shoes. I told you about the smart hairbrush. Digestion tracker. You want to see how your bowel movement is? There's an app for that.
It's essentially a fart predictor, a high-tech fart predictor. That's what it says in the Irish Times.
Irish Times, bro. See, look. Let's be honest about this here, right? There's like the really big like technology, science today, or whatever the hell thing, you know. Whatever.
That's not us.
Yeah, right.
It's not them either.
It's not them. Smart TQ. Levitating speakers, that's just cool for the hell of it.
I mean, they had them a few years back, and it's like, they look cool, but they don't, if they're not sounding amazing, who cares?
You like, know some what? People buy you know it. What marketing, bro, because Beat headphones suck.
Oh, they got better, but yeah. They're still not on the top of my list of shit.
You know, I still use my Bose.
Yeah.
My Bose speakers are ridiculous. My headphones are, like, they're the best.
Can't beat them. I got the QC35, so it's amazing. Took them on a plane, I was like, oh my god, I see why,
Let's go to England. See, but that's, they got a wearable section, so this is probably like wearable stuff. Back to the, everyone's really talking about that smart hairbrush. Benji Lock. What the hell is this? Mono spin on the tried and tested padlock format by whacking a fingerprint sensor on a padlock.
Yeah, it's just like should have been done.
Yeah. Mowing the
shower.
Yeah, we're pretty much wrapping
up. Past an hour.
Are we?
Yeah.
Nice.
Hour 8.
Nice. Well, you know what? I think that's pretty much it for now. I mean, this is the thing, though. There's so much, like, definitely keep an eye on his website to show what's coming up on CES.
Do what I can. I'm not sleeping. So.
Yeah, you're really not. Matter of fact, yeah, you're really not. What time is it? Yeah, you're really not.
I go home, chop this up, do some more stuff, then go back.
We really need to chop it up, just throw it in together and see what happens. See, this is the thing, is remember that you know, we still have jobs. So, guys, thank you so much for showing up on 8? 9?
What, today?
Yeah, how many episodes in? 9?
Oh, shit, this is episode 9. I wouldn't say. I thought you were looking at the date. I'm like, no.
You know what, honestly, announcing which episode we're on doesn't really matter anymore. It's more like, listen, let's just have another day and see what happens.
Yep.
You know, let's say some things that will piss off more people. And this one was actually not that bad. This was actually this was probably the most techie, like.
There was another. Last week was pretty techie too.
Was it?
It was a balance. Yeah, it was. It was more techie than movie stuff.
And that's true.
But.
Yeah, but there was a lot of movies.
Yeah.
But
there's nothing going on to see. Yeah, everybody's still on vacation.
Yeah, I mean, what I think. It's going to end up happening is there's going to be, you know, you're going to see us come in waves. There's going to be tech stuff. I know we're talking about getting more guests in and stuff like that. I know there's a couple of your tech peoples like that you know want to come in and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So, you know, they'll probably.
Go pick them up from Newark.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
You're on your own, bro. I'll be here.
Yeah, I know.
You know? Like, you're on your own for that one. But yeah, I mean, we're definitely going to be having guests, and I might, I've been getting invited to other podcasts.
Do it.
To guest stuff in them, and.
To guest stuff in them?
Guest appear, I don't know what you call
to
it.
Guest appear in them?
There you go, is that how you say it?
Yes, I don't know, like,
I don't know. But, you know, to guest appear in them, so you might see me in other podcasts.
Do they have video?
I don't know.
Most people, I'm saying, you just see them.
Well, you know, do that, or I'm. You know what I'm also thinking? I'm also thinking about starting my own podcast. Not in bad.
Told you.
It's not that I don't like you.
I've been telling you to do that.
No, but you know, I'm still trying. I'm thinking about it because you know I'm here.
Like, you got this. You know, you got to make sense with your time too.
Yeah, you know, and it has to be something about that. You know, something that I like to work out. So I still got to figure that part out.
Yeah.
But it's definitely something I'm thinking about. You know, let me know what you think. I appreciate it. And, yeah, I think that's pretty much about it. You know?
Okay.
So, guys, that's the show for today. Thank you very much.
Two wings. Stop.
Oh, dude. Oh, yo, hold up. Yeah, yo. I tried Atomic yesterday.
How
right?
Yeah. Was
it? Man, I'm hurting today.
Really?
In the bathroom. Yeah.
I didn't think it'd be that bad because you had the second one. You're like, eh.
No, it wasn't that bad at all.
Uh-huh.
It wasn't that bad. It was spicy. Okay. Wingstop, if you don't know, is like a buffalo chicken wing restaurant.
Chicken.
Yeah, it's a chicken wing spot.
If you heard any Rick, if you listen to Rick Ross, he advertises all the time.
Yeah, and
lemon pepper is the shit.
It is. Oh, I did the lemon pepper fries. Oh man, bro, that was it.
Yeah.
So yesterday, he put me up on it, and you know, he gave me like the second hottest one. It wasn't that hot, so I was like, all right, let me go there, whatever. And I ordered the regular buffalo wings.
Yeah.
Which is cool, and then I ordered the Atomic, which is like the hottest thing they have, just to see. You know, I was like, all right, let me just try that if I could do the other one. They bring them out, right? Have you seen the Atomic?
I
haven't
seen
it. Dude, it's like, it's like a dark burgundy sauce, dude. Like, and you can see peppercorn and flakes in it. Oh, man, I saw that thing. I'm like, oh, I'm going to feel this one, right?
My gaping ass.
For real. Yo, so, you know, I had that, and I ordered lemon pepper fries, and I had the regular hot sauce. So I was like, you know what, let me start with the hottest one, and let me get that out of the way, and I'll actually cool it down with the less hot sauce. Think about how hot this thing must have been. Just looking at it, it was like a dark burgundy.
Sounds like a terrible strategy.
Oh, man, bro. It was pretty epic. So I did that, and it was hot, dude. I'm not even going to try to lie about it. And it was hot, but I wasn't dying or anything like that. You know what I mean? So, let me see if there's a picture of it, Atomic. And it kicked my butt. I still ate the damn thing, but that's how it looks like.
Oh, fuck no, I'm not. I'm not good with spicy stuff. Back in my head.
It was like that. Look at that.
Yeah, that just looks like.
Oh man, bro.
Calling out.
Yo, you felt your soul burn, bro. Look at that thing. Oh man, it was.
It looks good though.
Oh, it was delicious. It actually had taste, but it was like hot as hell.
Yeah, because a lot of times you see these hot stuff, it just be hot and it tastes like hot.
Yeah,
it doesn't
see
taste
that peppercorns and stuff like
that. Actually, looks really good.
Yeah, it was good, but it was hot. Yeah. You know what I mean? So that, and I used the regular buffalo sauce to cool it down afterwards, and it actually worked. That's the funny part. It actually worked, but yeah, that thing was hot as hell.
So next time you have to try the spicy Korean.
I'll probably try
it's
that.
It's like a limited, thing, so you should try it before it goes.
Yeah, because I'm definitely going to be trying other hot sauce, because like, yeah, the food was good there. I ain't going to lie about it, it was good.
All the time.
So
probably
yeah.
Go there on the way to work.
Yeah, so, you know, you might end up seeing us talk, like, food stuff.
You might see us with Wingstop here one day, like, yeah, we had to do it.
You know what's funny? I personally wouldn't mind, like, eating and talking at the same time, just for the hell of it. It'll add a dynamic, I'll tell you that much.
That sounds like an entire different podcast that we need to create.
Exactly. that's what I'm trying. But you see, there's a couple of podcasts like that, like the First Week Feed Hot Ones.
I love that.
Oh man, bro, that's one of the best shows ever. If you haven't seen it, see it. Oh,
it's on YouTube.
Yo, this guy's really is trying to kill people, and Rachel Way is the baddest chick on planet Earth, bro. Like, if you haven't seen that one,
that was the Thanksgiving one. I saw it.
There was a Thanksgiving. What it is that you try the hottest hot sauces on chicken wings, and you. Get interviewed.
She said, fuck the wings.
She said, fuck the wings. Put it on a spoon, and I'm just drinking all of them. and every time she was like, yeah, that's hot. Like, yeah, it's got a nutty flavor at the end. And she was like describing the heat with no problem. Everyone else was dying. Literally. And she was like, yeah, that's not bad.
The last one, she started to sweat a little
bit. Last one, finally.
Yeah.
She was like, yo, she was like, makeup artist is mad at me. It was like that. It was good, though. But, yeah, so we'll probably end up doing, we're just going to start doing random stuff, too. Yeah. I really do think it'll work out with us, you know? But, yeah, I mean, we've been trying to close the show for like 10 minutes now. So, guys, guys, let's get out of here. We'll talk to you guys later, all right?
Peace.
Peace.